morning to all. Today, we are here to celebrate Gandhi Jayanti. Gandhi Jayanti is celebrated on 2nd October every year to mark the birth anniversary of Mahatma Gandhi. Gandhiji is known as the father of our nation as he led India on its freedom movement along with other national leaders against the British rule in India. Gandhi Jayanti is also celebrated as the International Day of Nonviolence by the United Nations. The word Mahatma means great soul. Mahatma Gandhi's full name was Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi. He was first called Mahatma by Rabindranath Tagore because of his lifestyle and way of thinking.
एक ओंकार सतनाम कर्ता पुरख निरपो निर्वैर अकाल मूरत अजूनी सैभंग गुरु प्रसाद जप आद सच जुगाद सच है भी सच नानक होसी भी सच। एकंकार सतनाम कर्ता पुरख निर्भो निर्वैर अकाल मूरत अजूनी सैभं। गुरु प्रसाद जप आद सच जुगाद सच है भी सच नानक होसी भी सच।
Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
Gandhiji's made to the modern world. Gandhiji's Satyagraha offered a solution to conflicts without the use of physical force. Truth, non-violence and self-suffering form the basis of Satyagraha. I am reminded of Gandhiji's words, "Truth and non-violence are my God."
Mahatma Gandhiji's contribution to education. Gandhiji's contribution to education is unique in this sense that he made the first attempt to develop an indigenous scheme of education in British India. Education system proposed by Mahatma Gandhi is called as basic education. He mainly aims at the education in mother tongue and asks for activity-centered education to make the children skilled and independent. He wished that some local craft should be made as medium of education for children so that they develop their mind, body and soul in a harmonious way and also meet the needs of their future life, which our National Education Policy 2020 has also focused on. Such kind of educational thoughts are relevant for development and providing solutions of the current problems like unemployment, poverty, corruption and many others.
Cleanliness is the symbol of dignity, health and safety. Proper hygiene and sanitation are also the indicators of social and economic development. Mahatma Gandhi once said, "Sanitation is more important than independence." He further added that unless we rid ourselves of our dirty habits, Swaraj can have no value for us. Even today, Gandhiji's idea of cleanliness and sanitation continues to be propagated in both letter and spirit. On 2nd October 2014, the Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi launched a nationwide sanitation campaign, Swachh Bharat Abhiyan, on the occasion of Mahatma Gandhi's birth anniversary, with the aim of making India an absolute Swachh country. Our Prime Minister Narendra Modi said that the Swachh Bharat mission is stimulated by patriotism and is beyond politics. This idea turned the thoughts of the people to Gandhiji's idea of cleanliness. Gandhiji, in his writings on sanitation, always insisted on the importance of cleanliness. Mahatma Gandhi took cleanliness to the level of spirituality. He had a firm belief in the proverb, "Cleanliness is next to godliness." He wrote, "We can no more gain God's blessings with an unclean body than with an unclean mind. A clean body cannot reside in an unclean city." Gandhiji saw cleanliness as an important aspect to reach or access God.
Women empowerment may mean equal status to women and provide opportunity and freedom to develop them. For Gandhiji, the goal of empowerment, he believes, depends on the threefold revaluation. Firstly, to change in their lives. Secondly, to create the change in their life. And thirdly, to change the social structure. Gandhiji saw women not as objects of reform, but as self-conscious objects. During the freedom struggle in the 1930s, Gandhiji exhorted women to take part in the Satyagraha movement at par with men. Around 17,000 out of 30,000 people arrested during the Salt Satyagraha were women volunteers, which is a conspicuous example of equal role under the leadership of Mahatma Gandhi. Not only this, in India, before independence, only a small minority was allowed to vote, and they therefore came together to determine the fate of the majority. Many people, including Gandhiji, shocked at the unfairness of this practice, demanded that all adults have the right to vote, giving rise to the universal adult franchise. After India gained independence,
Mahatma Gandhi says in his book, The Voice of Truth, "No one can or should ride on another's back." Self-reliant India, a long-awaited dream of the country, finally eventuates. The movement, through its remarkable ideas, aims for India to blossom with prosperity. Inspired by the Swadeshi call, India will no longer be a subject of imperialistic schemes. The five pillars of Atmanirbhar Bharat are economy, infrastructure, system, demography, and demand. Gandhiji emphasized on the development of small-scale industries, which plays a very important role in the economy. He promoted the wearing of khadi through the charka. He also laid the foundation of an India which would be self-sufficient. His reflections awakens the very spirit of nationalism in us. Hence, it's the duty of every atom of an Indian to contribute in this campaign to triumph over adversity.
Mahatma Gandhi was a man who was considered to be the greatest person by many of the history's most important personalities. He was the one who took the charge to repurpose our minds and behavior and made us realize that an eye for an eye would leave the world blind. He too was human and was even thrown out of the train by a Britisher because he sat on a seat he had paid for. But unlike an average human, he did not give in to his exploitation and fought back with an iron hand. As Louis Fisher later stated, had that foolish Britisher known, the man he was throwing out the train would one day eradicate the British Empire he was so full of, he would have not dared to make that blunder. Gandhiji believed in truth and non-violence, or ahimsa. He was the visionary who promoted women empowerment, as he knew that it was a diamond in the rough waiting to be polished that would take India ahead by leaps and bounds. He aspired not only for political freedom, but for true freedom, be it in the education sector or spiritually, and wanted to give equality to all. He wanted India to be self-reliant and free, both physically and mentally. Mahatma Gandhi's vision for India was to be united and progressive, and believed in the philosophy Ek Bharat, Shreshth Bharat. He may not be with us physically today, but his legacy lives on through his ideals. And today, I proudly say that Gandhi is not a person, but a way of life. He truly was a Mahatma in every essence of the word.
Thank you. Dear students, teachers and parents, the world knows glory in many names. There are some who are great on account of their military achievements, and there are some whose inventions and discoveries have transformed the way we live. But Mahatma Gandhiji stands in a unique category of his own. He was the father of a unique way of living in which he emphasized on waging peace and not making wars. The moral universe was his field of action, and his weapons were truth and non-violence. He envisaged making this world a better place to live in by bringing about some radical changes in our society and changing people's perception. Today, we celebrate the 151st birthday of the Mahatma, the father of our nation, most affectionately called as Bapuji. I am glad that the Social Service Department and the Heritage Club of the school have come forward to celebrate Gandhi Jayanti with the entire fraternity of the school. During the past 1 year, we created many special occasions in the school to celebrate the Mahatma: our annual day, exhibition on Gandhiji, display of Gandhian coats on flexes, and many competitions based on Gandhiji were proof of this. My hearty congratulations to the teachers and students who have today prepared a digital celebration to conclude a celebration of the 150 years of Gandhiji and honor the father of our nation. Gandhiji's philosophies and teachings give a beacon of hope that the world can still become a better place to live in. Gandhiji lived in a time characterized by political upheavals, social discrimination, and moral degradation. He came up with principles tested in the furnace of his own experiences. His way of fighting was unique and inspirational. His ideas of establishing a new social order hinged on non-violence and truth. The contemporary society will do well to avoid the 7 deadly sins that Mahatma Gandhi said will destroy us: wealth without work, pleasure without conscience, knowledge without character, commerce without morality, science without humanity, religion without sacrifice, and politics without principle. Gandhian principles hold significance in our times. Emancipation of mankind from the evils and ills of contemporary lives seem to depend on some of the key principles propagated by Gandhiji: faith, truth, non-violence, vegetarianism, brahmacharya, and simplicity. The influence of Gandhi on the course of human history is almost without a parallel. It is rightly said that Gandhi belongs not only to India, but to the whole world. He is not only for our times, but for all times. And he will continue to have relevance throughout the coming ages. Dear students, teachers and parents, we in India are trying to create an Atmanirbhar Bharat. For this, we need, as our Honorable Prime Minister Sri Narendra Modi has said, we need to be ready to reform, perform and transform. Gandhiji gave courage millions globally for becoming self-reliant, and he envisioned a world where every citizen has dignity and prosperity. It is important that we remain passionate about the great ideals of Mahatma Gandhiji. Let his vision continue to be our inspiration and his legacy become ours to continue as each one of us in our turn become a Gandhi in action for our country and the world. Thank you. Happy Gandhi Jayanti.
Martin Luther King quoted that Gandhiji resisted evil with as much vigor and power as the violent resistor, but he resisted with love instead of hate. True pacifism is not unrealistic submission to evil power. It is rather a courageous confrontation of evil by the power of love.
Dalai Lama spoke about Gandhiji on Martyrs' Day. He quoted that, "I have the greatest admiration and respect for Mahatma Gandhi. He was a great human being with a deep understanding of human nature. He made every effort to encourage the full development of the positive aspects of human potential and to reduce or restrain the negative. His life has inspired me ever since I was a small boy."
The great physicist Albert Einstein said that Gandhi's views were the most enlightened of all the political men at our time. We should strive to do things in his spirit, like we should use non-violence in fighting for our own cause, but by non-participating in anything that we believe is evil.
Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi is called a Mahatma because of his simple lifestyle and way of thinking by the great Indian poet and Nobel laureate Rabindranath Tagore. Rabindranath Tagore said, and I quote, "Mahatma Gandhiji came and stood at the door of India's destitute millions, clad as one of themselves, speaking to them in their own language. Who else has so unreservedly accepted the vast masses of Indian people as his flesh and blood? Truth awakens truth."
The former president of the United States of America, Mr. Barack Obama, said, "In my life, I have always looked to Mahatma Gandhi as an inspiration because he embodies the kind of transformational change that can be made when ordinary people come together to do extraordinary things.
I showed India and the world the path of truth and non-violence. I firmly believe that truth alone prevails in the end. India's real emancipation depends on Swadesh, use of khadi and cottage industry. Even today, the same values have been implemented as we are heading towards making our motherland Atmanirbhar. I was able to defeat the mighty British Empire with my brave followers, who did not use the sword or guns, but they had a strange and utterly new weapon of truth and non-violence. I worked hard for the abolition of untouchability, a sin against God and man. I appeal to the youth of the great nation to evolve themselves in the righteous conduct to make India Ek Bharat Shreshth Bharat of the 21st century. Jai Hind."
Oh, माटी पुकारे तुझे देश पुकारे आ जा रे अब आ जा रे भूले हम रहे हमें राह दिखा दे आ जा रे राह दिखा दे
ऐनक पहने लाठी पकड़े चलते थे वो शान से सालिम का पे थर 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 सुनकर उनका नाम रे हो कद था उनका छोटा सा और सरपट उनकी चाल रे दुबले से पतले से थे वो चलते सीना तान गे
बंदे में था दम बंदे मातरम बंदे में था दम बंदे मातरम
बना रे नफरत की आधी बहती रे वहशी दिलों को बापू प्यार सिखा दे आ जा रे बापू आ जा रे बचाले आ जा रे बापू मेरे
पीड़ पराई जान